engineers and technologists, they want to work on problems, not projects. Take zero. All right, so over the last few weeks, I've been traveling quite a bit. Last week, I was in Portugal to do consulting for an end user, a big manufacturer in the European Union. And then that was on Monday. And then Tuesday and Wednesday, I consulted with an OEM that makes an enterprise class MES system for four core verticals. And the week before that, I did the first IGP, the Integrated Growth Program workshop. So I had 21 integrators in the first IGP workshop. There was a common theme. There were many common themes across all three of those. So you had integrators I was talking to, you had a large enterprise manufacturer, and then you had an OEM that I was working with. And there were many common themes across the three, but there was one that really stood out. I was thinking about actually last night, I actually said this out loud. I'm like, well, engineers want to work on problems. They don't want to work on projects. And so it gave me the idea for this video because I wanted to talk about specifically one of the challenges that the industry has been having with is the recruitment and retention of the employee of the future. One of the mandates of the Integrator Growth Program is we are helping integrators scale. So Industry 4 integrators scale. And we have this, of the 21 integrators, you have integrators that haven't even been started yet. Like you literally have the founder in the program. They haven't even started the business. You have companies that are 20 years old that have 50 employees in there. You have integrators that have just the founder. You have integrators that got 5 to 10. You got this entire cross section of integrators is represented in the IGP program. And interestingly, they all are having problem recruiting and retaining the employee of the future. When I went to go meet with the manufacturer who has, I think it's 14 locations all over the world, they're in a continuous process in industry. They're a world leader in their industry. I did a DTMA with them, like a mini DTMA. So I had to do all my meetings in one day. And I did architectural meeting and the leadership meeting before I actually went on site in Portugal. And when I was meeting with the quality group, so one of the things that really stood out is that the vast majority of the people in this organization are mechanical engineers. So the number one education that I came across was mechanical engineering, and then chemical engineering was number two. Well, I was meeting with the quality group, and in the quality group, they had three quality engineers who were all young. They were all under the age of 30, and they were disproportionately represented in that group. The average age of an employee at this facility was in their 40s, and they had no young people except for these young quality engineers. And one of the challenges they're facing is recruiting and retaining the employee of the future. And so when I met with these quality engineers, I had conversations specifically with them about their challenges around digital. And then when I met with the OEM on Tuesday and Wednesday, there was one person in particular in the meetings that I was having who I really wanted to have the conversation with. So we did 2 days of strategy sessions in their conference room. And it was, you know, the high level leaders in their organization. They're a very large OEM. I think they've got like 500 employees. And that's big in industry for software. There was one person I wanted to talk to who was representative of the employee of the future. They were in the room, and I spent the vast majority of my time talking to this guy on day two. He had worked in the product side of the business initially, and then he left, and then he came back, and he was in services, and then I think he left again and came back, and now he's in like their community building group. And he was representative of the employee of the future, who you could tell he was the one who freely shared with me his frustrations with the organization, kind of the thing that, you know, he thinks the company doesn't get. Same thing for the quality engineers at this end user. And then it was representative of the problems that the integrators are having. And it's this: at the end of the day, there's a high level purpose here that we're all looking for. All of us want to be part of something bigger than us. Okay. Number two, there is a lower level, which is we want to feel productive, right? Engineers want to focus on problems. They don't want to work on projects. And one of the things that absolutely stood out to me to all three of these groups is they really struggle to tie what it is individuals are doing to the business problem they're trying to solve. Like when I was talking to the OEM on Tuesday and Wednesday, there were six primary goals for the engagement, and I had those at the top of my OneNote where I was, you know, asking all the questions. I kept going back to those six goals. If our six goals are this, then that. But the thing that I went to the most after that was, I still struggle with what problem you actually solve. Like, what is the problem the end user has that you solve? And obviously it's more than one, but you should be able to distill your core business down to a specific problem or a specific list of problems that you solve. And it was amazing to me that this OEM didn't understand the problem they were trying to solve for the end user. They really struggled to articulate it. And if the leadership struggles to articulate it, then how are they going to tie the work that this employee of the future does to the positive outcome for the end user? And the answer is you won't. So now what you've got is an engineer not working on problems, but working on projects. And that's fucking boring. Okay? People need to know how their work is connected to the solution. I mean, at the end of the day, if you're an engineer, if you're in the business of solving problems, okay, if you're an engineer or a technologist, that's what you are. You're a problem solver. Why is it organizations struggle to quantify the problem they're trying to solve? For example, I went back to this. Let's go back to the end user. This end user was one of the most, not the most. They are not a digital company. In fact, their digital fluency, very low. They're 30 to 40 on a scale of 0 to 100. But they were very strong in leadership and vision and strategy, but not everywhere else. Okay. However, their organization, the amount of efficiency that they had squeezed through manual processes out of their manufacturing operation was absolutely next level. It was literally the most optimized process I had ever seen outside of the digital world. They didn't do it digitally. Outside of the digital world, like what they're 5 years into the digital transformation journey. They went with one of the monoliths, okay? And part of the reason they brought me in was to make the case for why they should pivot from the monolith to Ignition, an ignition-based infrastructure using, you know, open unified namespace. And that was the reason they had me there. And they have a monolith there, okay? They have a unified monolithic stack, which is, it's actually a nice architecture, it really is. But they obviously know the problems with the platform they chose, okay? From one of the big, huge behemoths. But even they struggled to articulate the problem that they're trying to solve. And so when I was talking to the quality engineers about how their work ties to solving the business problem, they couldn't answer the question. Like, for example, they produce 93% good product. So their quality percentage is 93%, and they're confident in that number. I asked the quality engineers, how much is an additional 1% worth for your business? So if you were to increase your yield 1%, how much would that translate in for the business? And they couldn't answer the question. And that's the problem they're trying to solve. The problem they're trying to solve is gain 1% to yield X. It was staggering. You know, I just got off a call with my own team for the Prove It conference. And I think there were seven people in there. And I had highlighted, these are the three problems we're trying to solve right now. 1, 2, 3. And everything you do from here forward is in service of 1, 2, 3. And in our organization and the organizations that I work with, you know, integrators like Dotom and, you know, the many of the integrators that are part of the integrator growth program, many of the solutions providers who are industry 4 community, the problem they solve is on the forefront of everyone's mind. The problem they're trying to solve is literally on the forefront of everyone's mind. But it's amazing to me the number of organizations that hire me and spend $10,000 a day, $20,000 a day, $50,000 a day for me to evaluate their organization top to bottom. And it's amazing to me how many of them can't answer the question of what problem they solve if they're an OEM, or what problem they're trying to solve if they're an end user. And the integrator really struggles to answer for me, what are the 6 or 7 problems you solve the most? What are the 6 or 7 problems that you are solving the most for manufacturers that your engineers are working on? And all of you who are struggling to recruit and retain the employee of the future, it's because in no small part, you can't articulate what problem it is your technologists are even trying to solve. You just have them working on projects. And that's never going to work. It's never going to work. So ask yourself this question. OEM, integrator, end user. Can you clearly articulate the problem you're trying to solve? And can you tie the work that your engineers and your technologists are doing to solving that problem? And if you can't, save yourself a little bit of money. Save yourself $20,000 a day, $50,000 a day, $10,000 a day, and start there. Okay? All right, with that, like, subscribe, comment down below, and I'll see you in the next one.